Hello everyone, and welcome back to our inventory system series in Godot 4. In this video, we will be creating our inventory slots component, which will manage the functionality of individual inventory slots, and it is responsible for displaying item details, handling user interactions, and processing item usage and removal. This component is the most work of this entire system, so I'll probably split this part into a bunch of separate videos to make it more manageable. Without wasting time, let's open up our project and create a new scene. The root node should be a control node, just like we did with our inventory UI component. Rename this node to be inventory slot and save the scene in your scenes folder. We're also going to go ahead and attach a script to our scene and save it in our scripts folder. So since this inventory slot control node will house our individual inventory slot, we'll need to change its size. So on the inspector panel, change both its custom minimum size and size to be 150 on both the X and Y axes. We also want to give it an offset, so change its position to 10 on both the X and Y axes. Now, add a coloric node to the scene and rename it to outer border. Change this outer border's anchoring mode to be full rect and we'll change its color. Select your root node again and add another coloric node and rename this to inner border. We'll change its size to 140 on both the X and Y axes and change its anchoring mode to center. Let's also give it a new color. So your inner border will contain your item's icon and the quantity value. So let's add a sprite2d node and a label node to it. Rename the sprite2d node to be item icon and the label node to be item quantity. You can assign any texture to this icon, but we'll have to change its scale to 2.5. Then we'll center it by changing its position to 70 on both the X and Y axes. Then we'll change the text of our item quantity node to be 1, its font to Arcade Classic, and its size to 50 pixels. We'll also change the font color to be black. And then finally, we want it to be offset a bit more to the right, so change its x-axis position to be 5. Now select the root node of your scene and we'll add a new button node. Rename this button to item button and change its anchor mode to be full rect. Then underneath themes override and styles, we'll select the new style box empty on its normal parameter to give it a transparent color. So the purpose of this button is that if the player hovers over this button, we will show a details menu showing the player the item name, type, and effect. If the player clicks on this button, it will show a different menu that will allow the player to choose between using the item or dropping the item. Let's create the first menu that will show the details of the item. So select your root node again and add a new coloric node. Rename this node to details panel. And then we'll change its size to be 240 on the x-axis and 130 on the y-axis. We also want to move it above the slot, so change its position property on the y-axis to -135. We'll then also change the color of this border to be the same color of our outer border. Now to this details panel, we need to add 3 label nodes. Rename the first label to item name and change its anchor mode to top left and its X position to be 5. Then change its font to Arcade Classic with a size of 40. We'll also change its color to 131313. Then the second label will rename to item type, change its anchor to center left, and its X position to 5. Also change its font to Arcade Classic size 40, but this time we'll change the font color to be a little bit lighter. So it will be 131313C8. And then finally change the third label's name to be Item Effect, its anchor mode to be bottom left, and its X position to 5. Also change its font to Arcade Classic size 40, but this time with an even lighter color. So it will be 131313C6. And this is the final details panel. Now we need to create the panel that will show when our player presses the button, which will allow our player to choose between using or dropping an item. So hide your details panel and add a new coloric node to your scene. Rename this panel to be usage panel. We'll change its color to the color of our outer border. And then we'll change its size to be 240 on the x-axis and 130 on the y-axis. Just like we did with our details panel, we'll change its y-position to negative 135. So to this node, let's add two button nodes. Rename the first button to be use button and its text to use. And then rename the second button to be drop button and change its text to drop. Now select your use button node and change its size to 230 on the x-axis and 43 on the y-axis. We also want to change its anchoring mode to be center top. And then finally, we'll bring it down a bit by changing its Y position to 10. Just like with all the others, we'll change the font to Arcade Classic size 40. Now select your drop button, change its size to 230 on the X-axis and 43 on the Y-axis. And then also change its anchoring preset to be center bottom. We want to give it an offset at the bottom, so change its Y position to 71. And then finally, also change its font to Arcade Classic size 40. Then set the visibility of both panels to be hidden because we'll show them later on with our item button signals. Then select your item button and attach its pressed, mouse entered, and mouse exited signals to your script as the last step for this video. With our inventory slot created, we will split off this video for now so that in the next part we can get into the coding side of it. Luckily, most of our UI has been created, if not all of it, so we won't be having to deal with transform properties on Colorix anymore. Thank goodness, because I hate creating the UI. Let me know if there's someone out there who loves creating the UI because, I don't know, you're a unicorn in my eyes. That's it for this part, so thank you for watching, and I hope to see you in the next one.